Dear friends, today I welcome you to my second video message, which is part of the series dedicated to answering your questions. Thank you for the positive ratings of the first video, as well as the comments and questions you left. I will continue answering them in our next videos whenever possible. So, let's get started. For what reason Unitsky String Technologies Incorporated conducts parallel works in such a large number of areas? Do they all relate to UST technology? And if not, is it not a misuse of investments? 100% of the funds received by Unitsky String Technologies Incorporated is used in a targeted manner. Unfortunately, many investors do not fully understand what exactly they are investing in. Let us look into this issue. For example, Elon Musk started producing a Tesla electric car, and his investors understand what they have invested their money in. And if Elon Musk suddenly starts building highways, bridges, gas stations, and other elements of the transport and infrastructure complex called automobile transport, then he will be rightly accused of misuse of funds. This is because over more than a century-long history of the creation and development of the automotive industry, all its key elements have long been distributed and divided among many private companies and government agencies. Some companies design highways, second, lay asphalt, third, build bridges, fourth, produce cars, fifth, operate and maintain roads, sixth, build gas stations, seventh, build oil refineries, produce gasoline and diesel fuel, and so on. Of course, we can transfer the design and manufacture of an unmanned electric vehicle on steel wheels to outsourcing. But how much do you think it will cost then? And how much time will it take to produce it? After all, U-pods are not inferior to airplanes in their engineering complexity. The answer is simple: more than $100 million and at least 5 years for each model of an unmanned electric vehicle. But since 2015, we have already designed, manufactured, and tested 15 fundamentally different U-pods. Several more models of cargo, urban, and high-speed suspended and mounted U-pods are in the design and manufacturing stages. And this is not surprising. Take automobile transport as the global transport industry. Thousands of models of cars and trucks, buses, trolleybuses, and minibuses have already been created there. And more than $1 trillion in total has been spent on it. The following question arises: how can control be carried out on the side at every stage of the design, manufacture, and testing of a fundamentally new rolling stock that differs from a car, a train, and an airplane? After all, no one except us, the UST developers, is actually able to understand what kind of beast is an unmanned electric vehicle on steel wheels intended for driving on a pre-stressed flexible string rail transport over bars. There are thousands of parts and assemblies in an unmanned electric rail vehicle we call a U-pod, just like in an airplane, from bolts and nuts to copper wires and rare earth magnets in the motor wheels. For example, a U-pod has tens of kilometers of wires and electrical cables that need to be assembled into bundles individually for each car model according to a certain architecture. If this is not done correctly, accidents with human casualties are guaranteed. Therefore, there should also be architects of electrical wires among the designers. And in production, there should be highly qualified electricians, assemblers of these wires. Take, for example, any model of a motor wheel where there are hundreds of meters of special wires in the stator coils, and hundreds of rare earth magnets of a special configuration placed in special sockets of a specific rotor design. Each U-pod model has its own type of a motor wheel. It has its own power, its own speed, its own torque. This is the most complex electrical equipment and not every company, even a large one, is capable to create it. Along with the engine, no less complex control equipment and inverter must be created for each specific engine. Therefore, we have an electrical engineering laboratory, an electrical equipment design office, and an appropriate testing department.
И соответствующее испытательное подразделение.
If we take the U-Pod power frame, it must be strong, durable, and lightweight, and the requirements for it are at the same level as those applicable to the load-bearing frame of an aircraft. For example, even in a tram, the drive and the running bogey are the most complex, important, and expensive elements. The suspension of the steel wheel in a U-Pod differs significantly from both an automobile and a tram. The unique aerodynamics of our cars differs from the aerodynamics of both a car and an airplane. And we also have a U-Pod onboard automated control system, an automatic fire extinguishing system, a system of passenger evacuation from a vehicle stopped at height, and much, much more. And all this is of our own design. There is none of this on the world market, and it is impossible to buy it anywhere, neither yesterday nor today or tomorrow. This is why for rolling stock alone, there should be more than 20 specialized design offices, departments and laboratories, staffed by highly qualified specialists. Moreover, these structures should be individual. One for urban passenger rolling stock, second for high-speed intercity direction, third for freight direction, and so on. In addition, container transportation by U-Cons is one type of solution, while transportation of bulk cargo by U-Trucks and U-Transes are completely different engineering and technological solutions for cargo logistics. These are fundamentally different solutions, and they differ from each other in about the same way as, for example, a dump truck and a freight cable car. Let's look at anchoring structure under a horizontal load of about 1,000 tons, weight of 20 heavy tanks, applied at a height of about 10 meters. If it is improperly designed, it will either break or fall under load or drive along the ground, raising it like a powerful bulldozer. If any of these dangerous cases occurs, it will lead to the designer's imprisonment, while for Unitsky String Technologies Incorporated, everything will end in bankruptcy and zeroing of all your investments. Therefore, we must have specialists in the design of foundations who know the strength properties not only of concrete and reinforcement, but also of underlying soils, and there are dozens of them on the planet. We should also consider anchor nodes under a concentrated load of 1,000 tons, the support unit of the supporting tower, on which the span is attached, suspended, for example, a kilometer long and weighing more than 100 tons, dozens or even hundreds of powerful pre-stressed strings, and much, much more. Do not forget about the strength, static, and dynamic calculations of our unique, pre-stressed, continuous, and statically indeterminate transport overpass. Therefore, for the string rail overpass alone, there should be more than 10 design offices, departments, and laboratories staffed by highly qualified specialists. As for the transport infrastructure, here we have our own unique switches, a unique contact network, our own automated control system, special power supply and communication. Stations, train stations, cargo terminals and depots should also be our own, special ones, because they are located on the second level and cannot be borrowed from railway and automobile transport or aviation. Therefore, for infrastructure alone, there should be at least 10 design offices, departments and laboratories. I repeat, if all those works are outsourced, then think about what quality, what costs and time costs then we can talk about billions of dollars and tens of years, There are also other departments that are not engaged in the development of transport, but without which any company simply cannot function harmoniously. The legal division, the supply division, the patent and licensing service, and others. Therefore, if the work of UST group of companies is organized in a wrong way, and at the same time investments are misused, then nothing wonderful or even just nothing good will ever happen. That is why there are currently more than 60 divisions in the structure of Unitsky String Technologies Incorporated: design offices, laboratories, services, and departments. Over time, when entering a large number of targeted projects, the staff of the parent engineering company will expand by about one employee for every kilometer of UST roads designed and built annually. Then, for example, when reaching 1,000 kilometers of string roads per year, only the design management staff of our engineering company, Unitsky String Technologies Incorporated, currently there are less than 100 specialists working there, should grow to about 1,000 people. Otherwise, orders for the design and construction of string roads will not be fulfilled due to a shortage of personnel. And then, in the future, this department will be transformed into a separate legal entity, the UST Design Institute, with branches in different countries of the world. And our investors will become the owners of this future design institute, as well as of UST Incorporated.
Второй вопрос. Почему нет никаких сведений?
Why is there no information about the company financing? It is unclear where the money for development comes from. Since 2015, reports on audits carried out according to national and international standards have been available on the official website of the developer company of UST Transport and Infrastructure Solutions, namely engineering company Unitsky String Technologies Incorporated. They reflect information about the company's assets, equity, liabilities, profits and losses. After all, this is where UST Incorporated ultimately receives investments from all our investors after accumulating on the Sky World Community platform. And that is why it annually undergoes audits, which are available to investors in the public field. We prefer to keep confidentiality only in matters related to specific technical projects and technological know-how. This position is dictated by considerations of commercial secrecy and a number of other obligations to investors, as well as the goals of preventing the influence of information on negotiations with customers and non-disclosure of strategic plans to its main competitors. At the same time, information about the income and expenses of the main companies is not a trade secret and is publicly available. According to the latest annual report from FinExpertise Bell Audit, conducted in accordance with the requirements of the Law of the Republic of Belarus on auditing activities and the National Rules of Auditing, the financial statements reliably reflect in all the material aspects the current financial position of the company, the financial results of its activities, and changes in financial position, including cash flows, in each calendar year. Dear friends, thank you for your attention and the opportunity to talk to you, even if it is just online. I will continue to answer your questions in my next videos. See you soon.
И до новых встреч.